Okay, this is a walk around video of a barn find that we found here in central Wisconsin. I believe it to be about a 1975 Commuter three-wheeler. It was built by Commuter Industries in Cascade, Iowa. I believe it to be built from about the mid-70s through about 1982. There wasn't very much information on the internet on this. Only one YouTube on video could be found, and that is called Trike Mania. Some guy with a cowboy hat yelling while he's doing donuts in a pasture with it. So I thought that before we ship this thing off to the new buyer in Colorado, we would document it so that people, so the history won't be lost about this. Actually, this, I really enjoyed the short time I owned this. It has some unique features like rear suspension. Actually, it really helps a lot. It's the electric start with the option to put a rope around the engine and pull start it if your battery should go dead. This unit is really clean. It lived in a barn, or actually it lived in a heated garage. The original owner used it just to go out and carry bags of deer food out and bait the deer in his, on his property. Uses Goodyear tires. I believe these to be the original tires. I'm not sure on it. Size is 21 by 11 by 8. Kawasaki industrial motor. 341cc, 8.5 horsepower. It's a torque converter drive, just like a snowmobile. And it's actually quite a bit of fun to drive. The torque converter drivetrain works very well. Here it is with the body panels removed. One wing nut right here, and everything comes off. It's a metal gas tank with a fuel gauge like some snowmobiles from years ago. Nice cleanable air cleaner with instructions on the cover how to clean it properly. It's a combination of gauze like a K&N filter and some type of paper. Well, it looks like paper. If you try to oil it like a K&N, it'll run terrible. It's a special cleaning where they want you to mix a percentage of oil and kerosene and then soak it and then let it evaporate. And after I did that, it ran better. It ran terrible. It ran like the choke was on when I did it. Just the gauze like a K&N. It does have a little feature here where you can use a rope to start it if your battery goes dead for some reason. It's electric start. The battery wasn't held down that way originally. I could see signs of little posts like some cars have, but he also had a clamp on it, so I just used the same clamp. I don't know. I think the battery that was on it was a little larger. I just used a snowmobile battery from an Articat I had. There's the serial number. The brake is kind of interesting. It does work very well. Just a simple band around a disc. Looks crude, but it can easily lock up the rear tires at speed. Rear suspension works very nice. I don't know what is in that rear case. There's no drain plug that I could see to drain any kind of oil. I don't know if there's a chain in there or gears. So if anyone knows more about these, feel free to leave a comment on it. Like I said, there wasn't a lot of information on this. I wished I could have found more online. Researching this, it looks like it was built from about the mid-70s through about 1982. And after that, it was sold to, I believe the John Deere Company bought the rights to build this, and they turned it into a five-wheeler. And I forgot the name of what they called it, but it later became the current John Deere five-wheeler. Lights work. A simple toggle switch. This is the choke. I believe this to be about an early, or the early production, like 1975 or so, because later versions appear to have a plastic tank that is a little higher and above the seat. This one just has a metal tank with a plastic cover. But that's just my guessing on the best I could guess. Purpose of this video, like I said, is to show people what this was like. I couldn't find much on it, and I wished I could have found a video on it. So, trying to preserve the history here of these vintage machines. Hope you guys like the video. Feel free to comment if you know more than I do. This machine is on its way to Colorado. Buyer bought it on an eBay sale, but it was enjoyable to own, and it does run very well. I would estimate top speed to be about 30 miles an hour. Lots of pulling power. The motor is 8.5 horsepower, 341 cc. It's a Kawasaki industrial motor, and starts up real nice, runs real good, kind of loud. I did want to make a mention of that. I don't know if this is the original exhaust, but it just appears to be a straight pipe. Don't know if that's original or not, but that's all, folks. Hope you enjoy the video.